I'm here with Dr. Tim Pearce, the curator and head of the section of mollusks. Tim, let's talk about snail evolution. What does the fossil record tell us about the evolution of snails from living in water to living on land?
Oh my goodness, that's actually really interesting, because the there are land snail fossils from the Carboniferous period, so that's in the Paleozoic, before the dinosaurs. So the land snails appeared there in the fossil record, and then they disappeared for 50 million years until after the dinosaur age started, and then they reappeared. So land snails have definitely been around for at least 350 million years, but we don't know if they evolved once and then it went extinct and then evolved again, or if they evolved once and then they went into hiding for 50 million years. I don't know if you can hide that long. And then maybe if they went to a desert or something, because desert things don't fossilize very well. But snails don't survive very well in deserts either. So I don't know what happened. So it's a mystery. We don't know, did land snails evolve twice, or did they evolve once and hide out and then reappear?
So what sort of adaptations would snails need to make for it to be possible to live on land from living in water?
Well, that's also a very interesting question. because, well, land snails are kind of like leaky bags of water trying to survive on dry land. So you might think that the evolution would go from the ocean to fresh water, and then maybe they could figure out how to live on land. But if you think about, so I'm going to get a little scientific here, but osmosis. Now, living in salt water, the salt water is actually saltier than the inside of the body. So the water is actually moving out of the body. Well, in fresh water, it's the other way around. It's saltier inside. So that's really quite different. And it's the kidneys that are doing that. They have to figure out whether to save water or get rid of water. Now on land, the snails are losing water, just like they were in the salt water. So if you look at it from the kidneys perspective, from the osmosis perspective, it might actually be easier to go from salt water to land, because they're both losing water, and not from freshwater to land, because the freshwater is where they're having to do something different. A third possibility is they might have gone to brackish water. So brackish water is kind of halfway in between salt water and freshwater. You often find it at the mouths of rivers, where rivers meet the ocean. You get brackish water. And so there are snails that live there. It could have been that the snails moved from salt water to brackish water, and then from there, both freshwater and land. In fact, we do have some snails that still live in brackish areas that are very similar to, remember the ones that I mentioned from the Carboniferous period. This is much larger, mm-hmm. but these are similar to the ones from the Carboniferous period. They've got the teeth there, and they're similar shape. And so this could be something like the ancestor of both land and freshwater.
And where in the world do we find fossils that give us evidence about the transition from water to land?
Basically, anywhere in the world that you have Carboniferous deposits, you would probably find these early land snails.
And then nothing for 50 million years.
Right. So maybe somebody will discover some. Water snails have invaded land or moved onto land multiple times, independent times. And we know that because, for example, the land snails that we're familiar with, here are some pretty ones from Southeast Asia, or here's a local one, a local land snail. These snails do not have the door. They don't have an operculum. And if they were alive, they would have eyes on the tips of their tentacles. Mm-hmm. So there are other characteristics too, but those are characteristics of this group of snails we call pulmonates. So that's one invasion of land, but there were a number of other invasions of land and things that have opercula, or the door. So here's one group of snails, and you can see it there in the shell. It's got the door. That's one. Here's another one that's got a door. This is a separate movement from the ocean onto the land. Here's another one. This is much smaller. These are really common in the Caribbean area. Here's another one. This one, you can find these on Cuba. Here's another one this is also from Cuba, but a completely separate invention of terrestriality. So the the gastropods, the snails, moved from the water onto the land multiple times, at least 5 times, probably many, many more than that.
Wow. Thank you so much, Tim. That was really interesting.
Oh, you're really welcome. It was great to be here. Thanks for all your great questions.